Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignertechtips.com. Well, in this video, we're going to show you a free plugin to increase the page loading time of your website. I've got a website up here. It's a blog site. There's quite a lot of stuff on it. But if I have a look at the Google page speed, it's got a score of 83 on the desktop, which is fairly reasonable. It's the high end of average, just below fast. So I'm not too displeased with that. But if I look over here at the mobile site, then it's dreadful. It's slow. And I'm sure you all know that having a slow website will not only hurt you a little bit in the rankings, but people just don't like to wait for it. If it's going to take 10 seconds to load, 20 seconds before it's interactive, people are just going to move on. They're going to move on to something that's faster, that they can access whatever it was is they're looking for quicker. So I've found a plugin and it seems to work really well. It's called WP Touch. It's free. I'll put the URL just below this video if anybody wants to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and download it. Hit the download button there. There it is downloaded. So I'll go to my site, go to my dashboard. Oh, incidentally, to do that speed test, I've got Yoast installed here, which is another free plugin. You can get a premium version of it. Just add new plugin. You want to search, hit add new. And if you just put Yoast in there, there it is right there. And it's a free one. It's fantastic. 24,000 users, 5-star rating. Once you've got that installed, not only does it help you put keywords and everything into your pages and posts, but it allows you to get links to speed tests and all kind of things on their little Yoast thing here. You've got keyword research tools, analyzes page is what I used before. I just did the Google speed page test. Of course, you can go there manually, but this has it all built in. And Yoast is, well, I imagine it's the number one used in the world SEO optimizing plugin. Anyway, back to what we were doing. Here's that plugin, WP Touch, that I downloaded. So I want to hit the upload plugin button. I'm simply going to drag it over here to where it says no file chosen, or over that button there. And as you can see, it's put it in there. So I'm going to hit the install now. There we go. And I'll activate it. I'm using a caching plugin, which also increases the speed of your site by loading cached versions for people that have been there before. And have a look at this page here. I will put the link down below, as I said before. And they've got some frequently asked questions here. And it says, what if I'm using a caching plugin? And it's got the settings that you want to use for more of the well-known ones. It hasn't actually got the one that I've got here, but I've used that one before in the past. That's pretty good, super cache. But just have a look, so make sure you're going to configure it easily. And I'm not going to do any configuration. I've activated the plugin. There it is. And let's have a look, see what it says on its page. A lot of these features are only available in Pro. But like I say, I've just installed it and activated it. I'm not going to change anything. I had a look at my cache settings. I don't think that it's going to affect it in any way at all. So now let's go visit our site. And let's just make sure. There's our old settings. I'm going to leave this page up so we can compare. Desktop shouldn't make any difference. Now if I go up here, Gonna analyze this page. Google page speed test. There we go. Wow, look at that. Look at the increase there on the mobile. Before it was 15. Have a look at what it's rendered here. That's the regular site. And that was just a off-the-shelf theme, I believe. And 15. And now we've got it up to 61. So it's gone from slow to middle to high speed, which is a vast improvement. And this is what it's rendered. So it's going to look slightly different, but that's fine. Everything's still workable and usable. And there's probably some more optimizations I can do there. Shouldn't have made any difference to the desktop. 89. So 83. I think that's just down to the two different types, but that's pretty impressive. From 15 to 61 is good. So I think I'm going to leave that. I will check it out on my phone. But basically, I'm very pleased. And like I said, that's a free plugin. No configuration, just loaded it up and away we went. So there you go, guys. That was a quick video just on how to improve the speed of your website when you're looking at it on a mobile device, which is really important now because obviously so many people browse the internet with their mobile phones. I know I certainly do, and it's getting to be more and more all the time. So you want to make sure it does load pretty fast on that. So there you have it, short and sweet. I hope that's been useful to you. If it has, please give it a thumbs up and share it and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, take a look down below. We've got some great free courses. We've also got some premium courses down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.